Childhood abuse left artist Heather Johnson looking for any way to numb her pain.
Initially, I went and I started seeking self-medication. And I used drugs and alcohol and got very much involved in the counterculture scenes and was living a pretty destructive lifestyle.
And for a while, that seemed to work.
There was nothing that would be available to me that would make me feel better.
The birth of her daughter prompted Heather finally to reach out for help. The diagnosis, trauma, and massive clinical depression. She sought the help of licensed counselor Clementine Maltabay, who specializes in trauma recovery.
Generally speaking, the two sort of biggest effects, biggest damages that trauma has on an individual, psychological trauma, are a profound threat to a person's sense of safety in the world and a profound sense of powerlessness.
To treat those feelings, Dr. Maltabay uses a variety of tactics. One is talk therapy. Another one, and one that really appealed to Heather, is to use art and creativity as part of her treatments.
If we can occupy those brainwaves doing something like repeating, you know, a gesture of sewing or brush strokes, that kind of thing, then it allows for other states of consciousness, other brainwave states, to become more dominant.
And that allows the patient to start healing. Research now shows that these repetitive motions actually trigger the reward center in the brain, releasing a chemical called dopamine. Arts, exercise, even crafting can calm patients suffering from chronic pain, anxiety, even PTSD. That is exactly what happened to Heather through a combination of talk therapy and art therapy. She was able to find that place where her mind could finally find peace.
I'm just grounded within myself. I feel very stable and strong within myself, and a sense of peace is watching over me.
And Dr. Maltabay points out there are other very tangible rewards artistic pursuits often provide her patients.
There's a lot of value to being able to create something and have a tangible reward of I made this, and there's something very empowering about that, and it feeds a sense of self-efficacy, self-confidence, and that in turn can counteract some of those feelings of helplessness and powerlessness that so many people experience when they experience a trauma.
Heather Johnson explains it this way.
I found my happy place. I found that place where I feel most centered. I found my bliss.
Susan Hendricks, CNN.